So how much does it actually cost to fill up an EV? People always want to know that. Like, they're used to gas and how much it costs to fill up their car with gas, but they can't really understand the concept of how much does it cost to charge your car. It's actually somewhat confusing, so let me explain it to you. The most popular charging network around the country is actually the Tesla Supercharger network, and not just Teslas, but also Fords and Rivians and a bunch of other vehicles can now use the Tesla Supercharging network. But to give you a comparison, here at the Tesla network closest to me, you're looking at 52 cents per kilowatt for actual charging. That's a significant difference compared to your at-home rates, but it is possible to charge up very quickly here. Most superchargers will actually charge at 250 kilowatt per hour, which is very fast. So from zero to about 80%, you can charge pretty quickly on these, but it does get even faster than that. One of the largest and actually fastest public charging that you can find anywhere in the United States is actually Electrify America, which is right there. Unfortunately, as you can see, it's kind of under construction. They're putting new ones in, which is great news for people that need to use it. But theirs actually charges at a rate of 350 kilowatt an hour, which is extremely fast to recharge your vehicle. And surprisingly, as you can see in the current rate as of November 2024, 48 cents per kilowatt, which is actually cheaper than the supercharger network for public use. And it charges extremely fast, which is really nice. There are a lot of great apps that you can download on your phone, and also you can see them very conveniently in CarPlay if you do have an EV vehicle that has CarPlay, and one of them is called PlugShare. And what's cool about PlugShare is you can actually just see all the chargers that are around your area, and you can even filter them by price. So you could say, I wanna look for just chargers that are free of cost, which believe it or not, there are actually a lot of. And if you drive a gas vehicle, I don't know the last time you've ever pulled up to a gas station and the gas was free. So it's a really nice perk of EV. But you can filter these. You can say, I want to look for chargers that charge only at a rate of 250 kilowatt an hour or higher. Or you can say, I just want to look for ones that are free. Or I want to look for ones that are just specifically Tesla level 2 chargers, whatever it is. You can even, if you decided to have your own charging station in your driveway that you wanted to make available for people to see on this PlugShare app, you could literally put that in there. So the cool thing about this app is it will just show all the different chargers, whereas the Electrify America app will show just Electrify America, Teslas will show just Teslas. That one kind of shows a little bit of all those, and it's just nice and easy for you to just see where those are at. You can tap on it, it will give you more details in terms of how much it costs, what type of plug it actually is, and if there's a phone number associated with it for customer service, whatever it is, all that information is there, which is really nice. It shows the charging speeds as well. So it's a nice little convenient app. All the apps for the companies like ChargePoint and Electrify America and Tesla, they all have their own apps, which obviously will just show nothing but their own chargers. But I personally like the PlugShare one because you can see a little bit of them all. Now, the true cost savings, though, when it comes to an EV, is always and will always be home charging at your own level 2 charging. Now, what I have here currently is actually just an extension cable for a Tesla level 2 charger in my house. And I just have an adapter here for the J1772, you know, outlet that the Ford has, because my Ford one is getting installed next week. But this is really where the cost savings comes from. So let me try to explain this a little bit easier. Imagine we took a 100 mile trip. Maybe that's to work and back. Maybe that's just a weekend away, whatever it is. An average EV gets roughly 2.5 miles to kilowatt, meaning a 100 mile trip would take 40 kilowatts of total usage from the car. If we were driving a little faster, maybe we averaged 2 miles to kilowatt, which would then take 50 kilowatts for a 100 mile trip. Or maybe we were driving like a snail and we had no air conditioning or heat on whatsoever, and we got 3 miles to a kilowatt, that would only take 33 kilowatts of usage. Now, let's say we took that exact same 100 mile trip with our gas vehicle. If our vehicle got us 20 miles per gallon, that would take us 5 gallons. If we got 30 miles per gallon, that would take us about 3.2 gallons of gas. And if we got 40 miles per gallon, which is a really good efficient vehicle, that would take about 2.5 gallons of gas. So now, looking back at our EV costs, if we were at the Tesla Supercharger, which, if you remember correctly, is 52 cents a kilowatt for non-members, Electrify America, which is roughly 48 cents per kilowatt, and our home charging, which is 8 cents a kilowatt. By far, 8 cents a kilowatt is the cheapest. So if we took a look at that trip and what amount of kilowatts we use based on what efficiency we got, at a Tesla Supercharger, it would cost $20.80. At home, $3.20. At Electrify America, $19.20. If we didn't get as good of efficiency and we used 50 kilowatts, well, you're looking at $26 at Tesla, $24 at Electrify America, and $4 at home charging. Now let's take a look at the gas car, which might be about $3.75 a gallon, nationwide average, I would say. If we had a car that got us 20 miles per gallon, it would cost us $18.75. 30 miles per gallon would cost us $12. And a really fuel-efficient car that gets us 40 miles per gallon would cost $9.38, which is still three times the cost of our at-home charging. Now, in order for a gas vehicle to equal the efficiency and cost of an EV vehicle based on all the analytics that I just gave you, that gas car would have to get 117 miles per gallon at $3.75 a gallon to equal the same cost of an EV at $3.20 per 100 miles, or the equivalent of 64 cents a gallon for a 20 miles per gallon vehicle, and $1.12 a gallon for that 35 miles per gallon vehicle. So as you can see, home charging is significantly cheaper than any other option, gas included, even on a very efficient gas vehicle. Now, one important thing that I cannot forget to mention is that one of the greatest things about owning an EV is you would be surprised how many completely free chargers there are all around the country. You will see what are called destination chargers on some of these like SharePoint apps that basically are some level two charging that some people or hotels or airports or different people will put in their locations as just a perk for someone having an EV, and they are all over the entire country, and so many of them are free. So the Philadelphia airport, where I fly all the time, has tons of free chargers that you can have. Hotels down the street from me have free chargers. There are restaurants that have chargers. There are more and more going up everywhere because it's not really costing them much, and yet it's a nice little perk. But think about the last time that you went somewhere with your gas vehicle and there were gas stations lined up that just said free. And it doesn't matter if it takes 6 hours, 8 hours, 10 hours, or 20 hours to charge your vehicle. If it's free electric and you're going to be there anyway, being able to just charge and get free range is something that you can't say with any other vehicles. So yes, there are different rates everywhere you go, but there are also places that you could charge for free. And if you really wanted to, you could probably just search around and find free chargers and live on free chargers alone. You may find it a little bit inconvenient, but my whole point is, you can't deny that one of the great things about EVs is there are more and more of these free things popping up everywhere, and that's pretty awesome because I've never once in my life been given free gas. So there's that. Hopefully this wasn't too confusing, but I feel like it is kind of a confusing topic if you're not really understanding how EVs work and what their rates are. So I wanted to kind of show you what it looks like as of November 2024. And would love to know your thoughts and questions. If I can help in any way, feel free to comment below. And enjoy your new EV, or maybe you're not buying one now.